Hello and welcome to the management classes. Today in this video, we will discuss about the concept of tariff. Okay? What is tariff? A tariff is a tax or a duty, you can say, which is levied on the production when it crosses the national boundaries. Okay? So the money collected under a tariff is called a duty or a tariff duty, you can say, or a custom duty, you can say. Okay, so tariff used by the governments to generate revenue or to protect the domestic industries from international competition. So the government put these taxes on either import or export. So if they are levy these taxes on import or export, that means there is a difference between the export tariff and import tariff. So first we will discuss about the import tariff. What is import tariff? An import tariff is a tax collected on the imported items. When you import something from some other country, so what the tax levied by the government on that product is called a import tariff. It is basically, it is common, widespread and generally used tariff. If you talk about the tariff, generally we call it, this is import tariff. Okay, in other words, you can say that a tariff is a tax imposed by a government on goods imported from other countries that serve to increase the price and make import less desirable as compared to the domestic goods. When government imposes some taxes on the imports, so first of all there is a cost or the price of imported item, then government levies some taxes that increase the price of that product, which make it less desirable as compared to the domestic goods. So tariff generally introduces as a means of restricting trade from particular countries or reducing the importation of some specific types of goods. Okay, now we will discuss about the export tariff. What is export tariff? Simply the tariff which is imposed or the tax which is imposed on the export of any item is called a export tariff. But this is generally no longer used to a greater extent except to some of the minerals and agricultural products. Actually, several rich resource countries depends upon the export duties for much of their revenues. Export duty was commonly used in the past, however, and were significant element of mercantilist trade policies. Their main function was to safeguard the domestic suppliers rather than to raise their revenue, because by imposing some tax on the export, then you can affect the price if you are a big dealer. Okay, now it is also used by some of the developing nations, depending on whether the levying country is large or small. Large or small is not basically in terms of size, but in terms of ability to influence world price. You can take the example of a country like Ghana. Ghana is a very small country, but it is world top exporter of cocoa. Cocoa, it is the world top exporters of cocoa. So the government of Ghana levies tax on export to affect the world price. Now the question arises, what is the motive of levying these tariffs? You can say the reason for levying tariff. Generally, there are, broadly speaking, you can say there are two reasons. Number one is protective, And number one is to increase the revenue. Number one is protecting the domestic firms. Number two, increase the government revenue. So one is protective tariff and another is a revenue tariff. So what is protective tariff? Basically, protective tariff are, you can say, are taxes, duties, or other roadblocks. Generally, you can say with block here, the roadblock means generally is making the hindrance between the import or export, generally in the form of monetary fee. This placed on foreign goods by a nation or a state government in order to protect the domestic products and domestic market. So the increased fees levied on foreign goods are generally passed on to the customer, making the foreign goods considerably more expensive than similar goods produced within the country. As we discussed earlier, that imposing tax increases the price of a commodity. So the people who have been using the imported products may switch over to the domestic product. Okay, this system is designed to encourage the consumer to purchase more domestic products so that the domestic industries can grow. Otherwise, you can say that domestic industries incurred losses because of the availability of cheaper foreign products. Okay, this is protective tariff. Now, what is revenue tariff? Revenue tariff is a tax applied to imported and exported goods in order to increase the revenue, in order to increase the government revenue, you can say of a regional or a national government, any state government. Okay, in other words, you can say that a tariff imposed principally to raise the government revenue rather than to protect domestic industries is a revenue tariff. Now we will discuss about the types of tariff or the kinds of tariff. Broadly speaking, there are three types of tariff. Number one is specific tariff. Number two is ad valorem tariff. And the third is compound tariff. Means specific plus ad valorem became compound. Okay. Now we will take one by one. Now number one is specific tariff. So specific tariff are calculated in terms of fixed amount of money per physical unit of a imported product. Per unit, one product, that much fixed amount of tax or tariff. Two product, the same amount has to be multiplied by two. Say for example, one unit, $10 as tax. Two unit, 20, 3 unit, 30, and so on. If the tariff is 10 per unit. So this type of tariff is called a specific tariff. Here note that a specific tariff are never referenced as the percentages. They are always referred to in reference to a unit or quantity of unit or weight, you can say. Okay, and this is one of the form of trade barriers that is intended to restrict imports into a country. The second one is ad valorem. Ad valorem tariff is like a sales tax, you can say, like a sales tax. It expresses as a fixed percentage of the value of the imported product. A specific per physical unit, ad valorem, the value of the product import, value of the import product, a percentage on the value of a imported product. That means a tax whose amount is based on the value of the transaction, or it is typically imposed at the time of transaction, as in the case of sales tax or in the case of VAT, that is value added tax. Okay, you can take an example. Say for example, if some country has import a product, say for example $100,000, and there is a 2.5% as a sales tax. So when you multiply the $100,000 value with the 2.5% tax, then you will get a $2,500 as tax revenue. Okay, then the third one is compound tariff. Under the compound tariff, this is basically a combination of a specific and ad valorem tariff, and this is, that's why it's a combination, that's why it is called a compound tariff. In other words, you can say that it is a tax on imported goods that is a combination of fixed amount of tariff per physical unit and an amount based on the value of imported goods. Okay, so these are very simple to understand: a specific per physical unit, ad valorem based on the value of the product, imported product, and compound is combination of a specific tariff and ad valorem tariff. Okay, now we will discuss about the what is effective rate of protection. What is effective rate of protection? The effective rate of protection measures the net protection effect on producers of any product due to the structure of the production on both its inputs and its outputs. Or you can say that the effective rate of protection is a measure of the total effect of the entire tariff structure on the value added per unit of output when both intermediate as well as the final goods are imported. Okay, you can take the example of Dell company. When some of the inputs used in the production of desktop in the Dell company used in the production of desktop are imported, because Dell company have been manufacturing desktop in one country, but some few of the items they are importing from some other country. So the amount of protection given to the Dell depends not only on the tariff rate applies to desktops, but also on whether there are tariff on inputs used to produce these desktops. Okay, now under the effective rate of protection, there is a nominal tariff rate. What is nominal tariff rate? Basically, a rate of tariff based on the value of finished product. That is the nominal rate are of protection on any good in the proportional difference between its domestic and international price arising from the trade policies in questions. Okay, that means these policies can include import tariff, export tariff, or you can say the quantitative restrictions, that is the license requirements, prohibitions, rules of origins, local purchases requirement, etc., etc. Now, what is effective tariff rate? Effective tariff rate basically is taken into account not only the nominal tariff on finished goods, but also any tariff applied to import of the inputs. Means one thing is that there is a nominal tariff, okay, which is levied on the finished product, but effective tariff not includes only the nominal tariff, but it also includes the tariff which is applied on the imports of some inputs. Okay, so consequently it gives a better picture of the overall amount of protection that any given product receives. Okay, so It is related to the concept of value added. It measures the contribution of the capital and the labor at a given point of production. In general, the ERP, that is the effective tariff rate, is denoted by the by a formula. I'm going to write a formula here, which is effective rates. The effective rate of production is denoted by E. Okay, then we have a N minus AB upon 1 minus A. This is the formula which denotes the ERP, where E is stand for the effective rate of production, N is stand for the nominal tariff rate on the final products, A is stand for the ration of the value of the imported inputs to the value of finished product, then B is stand for the nominal tariff rate on the imported inputs. Okay, now we will discuss about the tariff escalation. What is tariff escalation? Basically, we can say that the imposing the higher import duties on the finished product and lower on the raw material. This is generally we said to be the tariff escalation. Basically, higher import duties on semi-processed products than on raw material, and higher on the finished products. So the nominal effective production increases at each stage of production. When production is started, the product is moving from one stage to another. On every stage, nominal and effective production increases. Okay, so this particular protects domestic processing industries and discouraging the development of processing activities in the countries where raw material originates, because this raw material now is shifting or importing to some other country where the production has been going on. This will become the incentive for the developing nation to expand the production of raw material, and it is this incentives for developing nations to compete in market for finished goods. So for some countries this supposed to be the incentive, but for others it could be disincentive. Okay, now we will discuss about the dodging import tariff. Dodging import tariff means if an individual or a firm escaping himself for paying the tariff, it's called a dodging import tariff. Okay, and this is broadly divided into two categories: tariff avoidance and tariff evasion. Both these tools are used to escaping the paying tariff, escaping from paying the tariff. But the difference is, the tariff avoidance, you can say, is a legal method of reducing or eliminating the amount paid in the form of tariff. This is a legal way or the legal method of reducing or eliminating the amount paid in the form of tax. But on the other hand, tariff evasion is a illegal means of reducing or eliminating tariff. It's a illegal way. Huh? The illegal way, you can say that the smuggling is one of the illegal way of making tariff evasion. Huh? Or you can say the false reclassification of products. Huh? Falsification of the country of origin. Or you can say altering the composition of the products. Huh? So there are so many different illegal ways which maybe help you to eliminate they eliminate you from paying the taxes, but these are absolutely illegal ways. So this is basic difference between the tariff avoidance and tariff evasion. In the tariff avoidance, this is a illegal tool to escape yourself to paying the tariff, and tariff evasion is an illegal way for escaping from paying the taxes. Okay, I hope the video will give you some benefit. If you like the video and you want to give some suggestions, please use the comment box.